So as I showed yesterday, if you go to that materials page of the website and scroll down to estimate space use with MCP, just click on that link for the code, and then you can copy and paste this in. That's what we'll be working with. And we're just going to be using that a data set that we exported from foie gras from the state space model, since it cleaned up our tracks a bit. So that is one thing I highly recommend doing, is if you do have tracks that do have location error, is to always account for that location error beforehand, especially from Argos tags, before estimating space use. Otherwise, that will introduce a bunch of potential error into these space use estimates and likely increase the size of that utilization distribution. Okay, so hopefully everyone's starting with a clean R environment from yesterday. If not, you can just go up to like session and hit restart R, and that'll clear everything out. So for this script, I'm using the tidyburst and lubridate packages again to estimate or measure the minimum convex polygons. I'm going to be using the AMT package. Otherwise, SF, R, Natural Earth, and Plotly were packages I used yesterday. And those are used for doing GIS-related work in R and for creating interactive plots. So I'm going to load these in. Should just take a second. Okay, and then I'm going to read in the data. Again, this will depend on your file structure or your directory, but I'm including this file path for process data as a folder. And then within that is my file. And I'm going to assign this to the DAT object and then briefly look at this summary of this data set, just to refresh everyone's memory. So we have 11 columns here that were exported from that state space model. So the first column is ID, then the date, then longitude latitude. Then we also have X and Y coordinates that are in kilometers in the world Mercator projection. And then our standard errors on those estimates of those locations. And then some measures of the behavioral states towards the end of that data frame. Okay. So we need to do some just basic data wrangling and preparation before we can start essentially processing these tracks. So the first thing we need to do, again, as per usual, is to convert this date variable from a character class to a date time class. So make sure you're essentially always doing this when you're handling animal movement data in general. And once that's done, we're going to use this make underscore track function from the AMT package. And we're first going to provide it the name of our data frame. We're going to provide it the names of the longitude and latitude columns or coordinates, as well as the dates in that date time formats, as well as providing the coordinate reference system, which in this case is 4326, the EPSG code for just an unprojected coordinate system in latitude, longitude. And I'm using the all calls arguments set equal to true so that I keep all of these other columns. And now if I run that and create this new object called dat track, it's prepared it in a certain format that we can use these functions from the AMT package on. So if I just print this object really quickly to show you what it looks like, it's now essentially renamed the latitude and longitude as these X underscore Y underscore columns. Date is now labeled as T underscore, and everything else looks essentially the same. Okay. So now to calculate minimum convex polygons, there are some different packages such as this one where you're actually able to calculate different, essentially like isoplex levels of a minimum convex polygon. So instead of just including all of the extreme outliers, similar to what you would do for other estimates of a utilization distribution, you can say at what percentage you want to estimate the MCP. So for this function, HR for home range, MCP minimum convex polygon, we're going to provide this data track object and then set the levels that we want to return these minimum convex polygons for. So in general, the ones that are most commonly used for space use estimation are at 50%, so 0.5. And that is typically considered to denote the core area of use. That's not necessarily the case, but that's how it's often referred to. And then to essentially try to ignore any outliers that may be present in your data sets, the 95% isoplet is used to essentially estimate the total area used. And then just to show the impact of the outliers, I'll also be including all of the points with a value of 100% or one here for that level. So if I run that and then print that object, we now see it also returns part of our data sets. It has this prod string, essentially, the coordinate reference system printed out. Because this is now a spatial layer, it shows the levels we're estimating at, as well as this SF object here at the very beginning, where there's a separate polygon for each level. And the level is its own column. It has a column labeled what, which shows that it's just an estimate. And it also even has a column that quantifies the area of that minimum convex polygon. Okay, so if we just use the plot function derived from that AMT package on this new object, and we can give it some colors to use for these polygons, we can now explore the overall space use pattern of all five of these tagged turtles. So if you remember from yesterday, we had five tagged individuals we're analyzing. So this blue polygon is showing the 50% or the core area generally of space use, which doesn't really seem to make much sense in this case. And then the green and the red polygons denote the 95% and 100% minimum convex polygons. And in this case, they're essentially overlapping almost entirely. So there's not really much of a difference at all. But you can see how this polygon, like this triangle that represents 95% of the data, covers this huge space of which the vast majority isn't even used by these turtles. So trying to say that the entire space covered by this polygon is the space that's used by these individuals for the population just doesn't make any sense. So there are better ways we can do this, but I'm going to continue moving forward to show how you can visualize these minimum convex polygons in different ways and even make these estimates on an individual basis rather than for all individuals of a population. So again, I'm going to load in this Brazil spatial vector and then make plots and ggplots to provide some geographical context here. And again, we can see that the 95% and 100% minimum convex polygons are essentially entirely overlapping. And the 50% is including a bunch of these early phases of the migratory period for three individuals. Okay, so again, that is for the population as a whole. But what if you wanted to do something like this for each individual separately? That is possible to do. And we're going to need to do a little bit of data wrangling in order to implement that. So we're going to start off with our dat track objects that we created from the AMT package. And then similar to some of our workflows from yesterday, we're going to break this up into a list by ID using this split function. And then once it's a list with each element as a separate individual, we're going to use the map function from the per package to basically say that we want to map the HRMCP function over each element separately. So we're creating a different minimum convex polygon per ID at the 95% isopleth or contour. From that, we want to just pluck or extract that spatial vector layer. That's all we're going to care about in this case, and then combine all these polygons together. So that's what this chunk of code is doing. And then I'm just defining a new column called ID to make sure this is easy to identify each of the different polygons, and then mapping this. And I'm also using ggplotly here so we can zoom in. So now we have a different 95% minimum convex polygon per turtle. So if I zoom in on this, we can see there's a bunch of points here that are kind of this corner for ID 205540. And something similar here for these other migratory individuals. But what if we want to look at the two resident individuals? We can zoom in on them as well. And that's going to be a little more difficult just because of all these layers. But we can see this yellow minimum convex polygon as one individual and this green one as another. So they're both resident here around Fernando de Noronha. Okay. And that's essentially it for minimum convex polygons. So I'm not going to really get into any more detail with that. In general, they're easy to implement, which is why I think they are still being used, but they aren't what I would say considerably useful in terms of estimating space use or making inferences about how animals are using the space around them. And I'm just going to export this at the very end of my script here so that I can use it to make some comparisons across the methods at the end of this presentation.